I found some videos about Mary Annie. She tell you about her story, about her life, and I wrote some questions that you can answer based on the videos you watch. So I think today you can watch some of the videos today in the lesson and start to answer the questions, and then maybe for homework you look again and you can watch the videos again at home and you answer the rest at home. And some of the questions, I think some of the questions, the answers are actually in the videos I taped. So if you can't find the answer in the video, you may need to go to Google. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Good.
She sells seashells by the seashore. Many have heard this old English rhyme, but few know the true story of the woman who inspired it. Her name was Mary Annie, and she did much more than sell seashells. She discovered some of the very first dinosaur fossils, and though she never received proper credit for it, she laid the groundwork for the entire field of paleontology.
Yes.
Watch them at home. I have also put on the question sheet, I've also put other videos you can watch if you have time, if you want to watch them. They might help you with some of the other questions if you can't find the answer in those two videos. So there's more here.
I think they can also go to Wikipedia, maybe they can find some information too.
Yes. There's lots of English websites, and I've written about her. You know, she's very well known in England, so you will find something online, I'm sure. So what shall we start looking at some questions?
There is a question over there. Yes.
But today, we are making more effort to talk about her and to celebrate her findings. In fact, I found out only very recently, I read the news.
Yes.
So, they are in England. They are going to make some coins. With designs of some of the dinosaurs or some of the creatures that she discovered. Does anyone know which coin, which piece this is? Do we know which one this is? It's large, it's one of the biggest ones, and it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sides. Does anyone know?
Okay.
If I show it to Aris.
50 pounds.
50 pounds.
Yes, with these all political and economic things. Yes, so it will be that 50p coin is like 60 cents.
Yeah.
Okay, more or less.
Yeah, more or less. Yeah. It's from the, in England, it's called the Victorian times. Because it was when Queen Victoria was queen, so we call it Victorian times, and this is the 19th century. Do you understand? Yes. Yes. So yes. She lived during the Victorian times.
Yes.
Example of names that people gave to the things that found the beach. The fifth question.
Oh, but if you don't have any information, you are going to look up for something for next day. Do you get the idea? Yes.
Okay, on to the next sheet. Did anyone find when Mary was born?
Yes, she was born.
When? No, where?
Where did she live? Did anyone get the name of the town where she lives?
Yes.
17,
Emma.
17. Lyme Regis, perfect. 17. Now, 17. I would say, shall I spell that for you now, or shall I let you look at the spelling? In those times, women were not as well celebrated and recognized for the work that they did, and especially as well because she was a poor woman. Like if she was a rich woman, she might have got some recognition. The fact that she also lived in a small town, she was poor, uneducated. She didn't live in London, a big city. You know, she was just some poor woman. Yes, and different colors. Yeah, lots of, you know, with lots of colors in churches, they made a window.